Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Let's Paint Mini. So I wanted to move on to some more Mansions of Madness, but this time we're going to do some heroes. And to do something special, we're going to do some heroes from one of the expansion packs. So what we're doing here are Tommy Muldoon and Finn Edwards. Now, they come from the expansion Streets of Arkham, I believe. Streets of Arkham. So we're going to go ahead and just do these two right here. They're the only two heroes that come with this expansion, so you'll be able to knock out all of the heroes that it comes with. All right, so the first thing that I did was I did a base coat of pure black. I just, took a base spray and I just, sprayed it. And the first thing that we're going to start with are their skin colors, and I imagine they're just going to have about the same complexions. They're probably just going to be pretty tan. So we're just going to start with some tan skin right here. Alright, I'm just going to take a medium-sized Reaper round brush here. This is just a one-scale Reaper round brush. I'll go ahead and get started here with Tommy. One of the reasons why I'm doing these characters is because these characters, especially my wife and I, are pretty fond of them. I really like to play as Tommy, and my wife really likes to play as Finn. So I thought, you know what, let's just knock out both of these characters. They're from the same expansion pack anyway, so it all works out. Let's just go ahead and knock them out here. Alright. All right, so I've got the face there for Tommy. Now I'm just going to go ahead and do his hands. Actually, wait. You know what? If we look at the artwork for his character card here, looks like he's wearing gloves actually. So I think that we're just going to leave the skin for Tommy like this. All right, so that's Tommy. Let's move on to Finn here. Now Finn's got a little bit more skin showing just because he's got some sleeves rolled up and he's not wearing any gloves. So let's start with the face, just because I tend to want to start with the faces, just because those are generally the more detailed parts. So one thing that you may have noticed when I do my faces here, I tend to just leave the eyes as black. And then when I do the eyes later on, I like to have a little bit of a kind of a black sort of base, and then I'll go over the eyes with white, and then I'll do some black to do the pupils on top of that. I don't know. I just find it helpful to have kind of a base of black around the eyes, just because kind of brings out the eyes a little bit more. If you've got a little tiny bit of black separating the eyes from the skin, it just kind of makes them stand out a little bit more. Something that you don't necessarily have to do the eyes if you don't want to. There's some people that just kind of don't bother with the Mansions of Madness miniatures. Something that a lot of people tend to do is they'll just do very, very basic coats of colors that they like. And then they'll use like a wash or a shade or something like that to bring out all the details and that kind of thing. And while there's certainly nothing wrong with that, it's not really the style that I tend to go for most of the time. Sometimes I'll do it if I'm feeling really, really lazy. But if I want to go ahead and just relax and just deal with paints and just kind of unwind and do this at my own pace and have a good time, I'll just use all, you know, regular paints and I'll use dry brushing techniques and all that, and it's just something that I'm rather fond of, and just ways that I like to paint miniatures. The other thing, too, is that it's easy to teach dry brushing, and you don't need to tell people to go out and buy a bunch of different shades and a bunch of different types of colors and all that. You can basically just teach a simple dry brushing method, and all you need are just the paints. That's all you need, is just a decent paint set. And you can crank out pretty much anything that you want. Don't know why, but Finn Edwards, as he is right now, just with the kind of his face shape and his hair, he kind of looks like Neo from The Matrix a little bit. But that'll probably change here soon. Okay, so I've got some tan skin on their skin there. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take some tanned highlight. It's basically the same kind of type of color, but it's just a little bit fairer. It's just gonna, you know, it's just a little bit lighter. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a dry brush. This is pretty much the only kind of like specialty thing that you need to get if you want to do dry brushing, is you just want to make sure to get a brush that's specifically made for dry brushing here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and dry brush the skin bits with this tanned highlight. And that will just kind of, yeah, give a little bit of depth, a little bit of highlight to all of the skin that we just did. There we go. That just brings out a little bit of detail, kind of brightens up the sharp lines of the face there. Kind of hard to tell on the camera right here, right now, but it'll be clearer when I take some good pictures for the end of the video. But yeah, just adds a little bit of depth, a little bit of shade to the face. All right, and now we'll move on to Finn, and we're just going to do the same thing. One thing is that when you are doing dry brushing like this, you might get a little bit of paint on like the clothes and the hair and that kind of thing. But with these miniatures, I'm not that worried about it because I'm actually going to go over pretty much all of the base coat here. So any kind of paint that you get on like for example here, the bottle or the hair or the jacket or anything like that, don't worry about it because we're going to go over those with another color. Okay, and I think that that'll be enough for that. I think that that'll work out. So I'm going to rinse off my dry brush that I was just using. All right, and I think I might want to have some fun with Finn first. So what I'm going to start with is if we look at the illustration on his character card, it looks like what he's wearing is just kind of a white button-up shirt and then a green jacket over that. And you can kind of see that in the miniature here. You can kind of see that he's wearing a jacket here. So we're going to start with the shirt underneath, and we're going to work our way out. You want to work your way on the deepest layers of a miniature and then work your way out. So like you would start with the skin and then like underclothing and then outer clothing and then equipment off of that. All right, so we're gonna start with the shirt there, and what we're gonna do is I'm gonna take some snow shadow here. All this really is just a really like a light gray kind of color. It's got a little bit of a blue tint to it, but that'll be fine for what we're doing right here. Got a little bit of paint on my finger there. That's okay. All right. All right, so we'll go back to that one brush that we were using, and we're just going to go ahead and do the shirt that he's wearing. You know, I'm not going to lie, the Mansions of Madness miniatures as a whole are really not that high quality. They're not very well detailed, they're not very well sculpted, they use kind of a cheap plastic. However, I will commend Fantasy Flight because the expansions for Mansions of Madness, especially with this one right here, with Streets of Arkham, the sculpts are much nicer. The plastic is a little bit thicker, the detail is nicer, so these miniatures overall are just a lot nicer. The monsters, too, I think you can get, like, some lone gunmen that are just kind of like, I don't know, they look like trench coat-wearing 1920s gangsters. They look really, really nice. So good job to Fantasy Flight for making those better. All right, so that's all that I'm going to do for that there. Now, one thing that you can do per the illustration is that it looks like part of his shirt is kind of showing through his sleeves there. I'm not going to worry about that. That's just an extra layer of detail that I really feel like is just a little bit more than we really want to do. What we want to do is we want to just do a really basic technique, a really, really basic paint job that anybody could do, that you could do. If you just put your mind to it, you know, you can accomplish it. So that's all that we're going to go ahead and do right now. Tell you what, while that's drying, I'm going to move back over to, I'm going to move back over to Tommy here. All right, now his color scheme is actually pretty monochromatic. He's actually got just mostly a really dark kind of purplish bluish. And I kind of really like a little bit of purple to show up, but I still kind of want it to be blue. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some Imperial Purple here. This is a really dark purplish color that's got a little bit of a blue tint to a little bit more blue than red, because you know obviously purple is a mixture of blue and red. This is very, very dark, and it's purple, but it's got a little bit more blue to it, which I think is going to be appropriate for a creepy 1920s Lovecraftian police officer. Okay, my paint little bottle is stuck up here. This is a little bit dry. Let me get my little safety pin. All right, I'm just gonna poke the nozzle of my paint bottle here. Just kind of spin it around, pull it back out. I think that that should be fine. Let's try that. Much better. Oh, you know what? I'm going to shake this up. It seems a little runny. Let's try that. That's a little bit better. All right, that'll work. All right, and just to save time, because again, it's he's wearing that outfit pretty much around his, wearing that color pretty much around his entire outfit. So I'm going to move on to a medium-sized base brush. It's just a little bit of a bigger brush, a little bit more surface area. It'll just help kind of get the job done a little bit faster. And to be honest, I'm not really concerned with the details right now, so I'm just going to go ahead and go over, like, everything, except for, like, the strap coming across his chest like this. I'll go ahead and leave that, you know, just for getting some practice in. For things like this, you can get some practice going around certain things, doing small details and that kind of thing. You know, anytime you ever get the opportunity to do that, because it's not going to matter if you, you know, if you mess up at all, go ahead and do it just to get some practice in. Oops, got a little bit of paint on my finger there a little bit, but that's okay. We'll be all right. And yeah, like I was saying earlier, it looks like he's wearing gloves that are mostly just the same color as the rest of his outfit, so we're just going to go ahead and go over his hands as well, as we have done. There we go. So there's Tommy with his purple police outfit there. So we'll go ahead and do that. All right, now we'll move on back to Finn. I'm going to rinse off the brush that I was using just a minute ago. All right. All right, using my dry brush again, I'm going to go ahead and get out some pure white here. Don't need very much paint at all, just a little itty-bitty tiny dot here. And I'm just going to dry brush his shirt with this pure white. So I'm going to use my my dry brush again. Just load up some paint on here, but wipe off most of it. That's why they call it dry brushing, is because you've got a decent amount of paint on your brush, but you've got a lot of it wiped off, actually, to the point where the brush is almost dry. So that's why they call it dry brushing. And then we're just going to really lightly just go over the shirt, kind of bring out the folds of his shirt a little bit, bring it all out. Now, as you can see, I'm getting a little bit of white onto his jacket here, but that's okay, because like I said, we want to start with the low contours, the deep layers of the sculpt, and we're going to work our way out. So we're actually going to go over the jacket with our green color. There we go, and I think that that'll work out. That brings a little bit of depth to his shirt there. Easy as that. Okay. All right, and next up, let's go ahead and do a little bit more with Finn. So let's go ahead and move on to the jacket. So again, he's got a nice green jacket, just regular standard, a little bit of a pale green kind of jacket there. What I'm going to take is some Muddy Olive right here. It's a really, really dark, kind of a muddy green color. And we're going to use that as the base coat for the jacket. I've used this color a lot, actually, because I used it when I was painting a lot of like Warhammer orcs a while ago. That was a few years ago. I've had this paint set for a while, which you can kind of tell because a lot of my paints are kind of dried up. But yeah, let's just go ahead and poke that little there, spin it around, get it out. There we go. I think that's fine. Oh, well, maybe. come on, paint. Oh, why are you playing hard to get? Oh, I think I might have gotten it. Okay. There we go. All right. All right, I'll just use that same brush that I was using earlier, that medium Reaper round brush. And yeah, let's just go ahead and go over all of his jacket here with this olive green color. I should maybe have started with his pants first. Since his pants are kind of underneath his jacket here, as you can kind of see, around like his kind of groin area and his hips, but that's okay, I think we'll be alright. I think that if you get a little bit of paint onto the rope that he's got kind of around his jacket here, I wouldn't be too worried about it. If you can, like I'm doing right here, try to go around it, but again, if you get a little bit of paint on it, I don't think it'll be the end of the world. I think you'll be all right. All right, so we've got most of his jacket here. I'm going to give him a little once over just to kind of look around at the whole thing, make sure I didn't miss any spots or anything like that. I think that that will be fine. All right, so I'm going to let him dry really quickly. And I think I'm going to move on back to Tommy here. And now we're going to go ahead and bring out the high points of all of his outfit here. So what we're going to do is we're going to move on to a kind of a brighter blue color. Not too bright, not too light. Just a nice blue color. So I'm just going to use a sapphire blue. This is what you would just call a blue color. I think that that'll work out, actually. All right, I'm going to move on back to my dry brush that I was using, and I'm just going to dry brush this light blue color, this just, you know, standard blue color, over that imperial purple, and hopefully that'll give a nice color scheme going here. A nice kind of police purple, or police blue, with a little bit of a hint of mystery to it with that purple base coat. Hopefully this will look pretty nice. Yeah, that's coming along nicely. That's got a nice cool color scheme going on here. I like that. Oop, a little bit too much. A little bit much. That's okay. There we go. That's good. All right. There we go. That's just got a nice kind of a blue police officer color. But it's got, like I said, just a little bit of a hint of mystery, a hint of that sort of Lovecraftian, creepy Cthulhu-esque kind of color scheme by using that purple as a base coat. I like that. That looks really nice. Okay, so now I'll move on back to Finn here. All right, so I'm going to rinse off my dry brush that I was just using because I'm going to use it again for Finn right here. Now, we're going to do a similar kind of thing where we're just going to dry brush his clothes here. But we're going to use a lighter shade of green. And again, I don't want it to be too bright, and I don't want it to be too dark or anything like that. So I'm just going to use some leaf green here. This is just a nice, solid green color. I like it. This is just going to be just decent little green color. So we're going to use that to highlight his jacket. All right, so the same kind of thing here. I'm just going to take my dry brush. I'm just going to load it up onto the... load the paint up onto the bristles of my brush here. I'm going to wipe off most of it. All right, let's go over that jacket. Yeah, there we go. That brings out his jacket nice and bright. That gives it a nice color there. I like that. Okay, so we've got most of the core colors set for both of them. All right, now we're going to move on to a couple of we're doing one thing, but we're going to be using the same kind of like a combination of colors for several things. So we're going to use some earth brown and some leather brown to kind of color and bring depth to their hair. It kind of looks like both of them have about the same hair color. It kind of looks like they both have just sort of, you know, brownish hair. So we're just gonna, you know, for simplicity's sake, stick with that. And Finn's pants aren't showing, but I kind of imagine they're just kind of like generic brownish, khaki-ish kind of pants that you would expect in, you know, 1920s garments. All right, so yeah, we're just gonna use that whole kind of like combination of colors for the both of them. So what I'm going to start off with is some earth brown here. And we're going to use this to coat their hair and Finn's pants. Oh, and you know what? We're also going to use it on Tommy's Becky here. The name of his rifle is Becky. We're just going to use it on the butt of his rifle and as the sort of like wood, you know, wood base that it's got too. All right. And I think, let's see here, can I do it? Yeah, you know what, I think I can get away with using that one medium base brush that I was using. I think it's going to make doing the pants a little bit easier, and I think that I can get away with doing the hair. I think I'll start with their hair first, since those are some finer details here, and it's, generally speaking, you want to start with the finer details while the point of your brush is still really, really sharp. Okay, so there's Finn's hair. Let's move on to Tommy's hair. They've both got pretty nice hair. They've both got very prim and proper hair. Well, I guess there wasn't a lot to do in the 1920s, so I guess a lot of guys probably just took care of their hair a lot more than today. Not to say that men today don't take care of their hair or anything like that, but I certainly don't. You've probably seen my hair in previous videos where I've, you've seen me talking for real, and you're like, that guy does not have nice hair. whatever. Doesn't matter. All right, there's Tommy's hair. Man, I really got a lot of paint on my fingertips. There we go. All right, I just found that a little bit distracting. My own personal thing, whatever. All right, so now we're going to move on to Finn's pants. And again, we're just going to use the same kind of color shtick here. And I think that with Finn, you can probably get away with just doing his boots the same color here, too. I think you'll be fine. Sometimes when it comes to painting miniatures, less is more. When you have too many colors and you have too many things going on with a particular miniature, it can just get a little bit visually busy, a little bit visually distracting. And especially when you've got a lot of miniatures, not really a huge deal with a game like Mansions of Madness that doesn't use a lot of miniatures at the same time, but for something like Warhammer, if you've got a lot of colors and you've got a lot going on, it's just a little bit visually busy, and to the untrained eye or to anyone who isn't really, really super into paints, it can just get it can just be a little bit samey to look at all of them all together. So I don't know, just generally speaking, I like to just keep really simple designs, really simple paint jobs, and I try not to overcomplicate things too much. You know, that's just kind of a creed that I like to live by, is just keep it simple, stupid. All right, and I think that will do nicely for the pants and for their hair there. All right, and let's rinse off that brush really quickly. All right, and then like I was saying, I'm gonna move back onto my to my medium brush here, and I'm going to go ahead and just get the butt of Tommy's gun here as well. Oh, and you know what? There's a little bit more that I want to do with Tommy here too. Using the same color scheme, color variety here. The sort of straps that he's got all over him, kind of the shoulder strap and that kind of thing. Let's go ahead and use that here as well. Okay, and I think that will be fine for Tommy there. Yeah, that looks pretty nice. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and stick with that. So at this point, we're just gonna move on to all of our details and that kind of thing. Oh well, I guess before we get any further, we're gonna dry brush all of those things that we just did, and we're going to use my very favorite shade of brown. This is a shade of brown that I use for everything, so many things. I use it for pants like this. I use it for wood. I use it for hair. I use it for, well, you know, as the title implies, I use it for leather. But you can also use it for like teeth and for nails and bones, and like there's so much that you can do with this color. I love it. It's a great color. All right, so let's go ahead and move back onto our dry brush that we were using, and we'll go ahead and just we're gonna touch up the hair for both of them, as well as Finn's pants and Tommy's belts. There we go. Yeah, you can just kind of see that brings out the layers of his hair a little bit more. Looks nice. Okay. And what we're going to do, too, while we've got this, is that rope that we had, we're going to go ahead and just dry brush some leather brown onto that rope. If you just leave it as black, I think that you'll be okay. Now, if when you were going over the jacket, you weren't able to go around the rope very evenly or very easily, you might just go over it with... you could just use the earth brown, or you could use, you could just use pure black, you know, whatever. But I think that if we just, dry brush some leather brown over the rope here, as it is right now, I think that that will work out just fine. Might not be, like, the best details, might not be the fanciest, but again, we're here to just kind of paint our worries away and have some fun painting some miniatures and just make them look nice. They don't need to look perfect. They just need to look nice. And they need to look like however you want them to look. That's pretty much it. There we go. That'll be fine. Yeah. Yeah, that works out just fine. Okay. Let's go ahead and go over his pants. Whoop! Throwing my brushes around everywhere. Yeah, there we go. That looks nice. So we'll stick with that. Alright, we're gonna do the same thing with Tommy over here. Just gonna go ahead and go over his hair. And the rifle. Alright, just kind of be a little bit careful when you're doing the straps here, because it can be kind of easy to get a little bit of this leather brown onto that that really nice blue color that you did. So just kind of be careful, kind of take your time, just really lightly apply it to the belts and the straps and all that. There we go. That looks nice. All right. So now we're just going to move on to all of our details and that kind of thing. And I think that to start, I'm going to start with Tommy's rifle here. I'm just going to get a little bit of some silver going or some steel going. So what I'm going to grab is some honed steel. This is just the steel color that I use for pretty much everything. I'm just going to get a little bit of paint out there. Don't need very much. Okay. I think what I'll use is I'll go ahead and use a small size Reaper round brush here. This is just a zero scale round brush. And we'll just go ahead and use that. Let's go ahead and get kind of the trigger here, as well as kind of a lock thing that's on the side there, as well as the, what is that called? The breech, where like the shell comes out of whenever you fire a round. I think that's what that's called. I don't know, as previously discussed in other videos, I'm not really a gun guy, so I don't really know a lot of the gun terminology and iconography and all that, but that's okay. There we go, that's just got that whole thing going. Let's get the top here. That trigger goes. There we go. That will function nicely. All right. That's about all that I wanted to do there. So I'm going to rinse that off. Next up, there's not a lot of detail to do with Finn here. So we're actually, I think I'm just going to leave him the way that he is for now. So that's good. But now let's move back on to Tommy here. And let's use some antique gold. And we're going to use that that antique gold for all of the buttons and for his buckle and his police badge there. I'll go ahead and use that one small brush that I was using just a minute ago. There we go. That looks nice. That looks like a nice, decorated, fancy police officer there. Okay. And now, let's get into the nitty-gritty of things here. Let's move back to some pure white, and let's go ahead and do those eyes that we were talking about earlier. All right, so I'm going to move on to a really itty-bitty, teeny-tiny, little tiny micro detail brush here. It's so small it barely even shows up on the camera. And again, you do not have to do this. If you decide that you don't want to do the eyes or anything like that, just go ahead and go over all of the face with that skin color, and honestly, you'll be fine. This is just something that I kind of like to do kind of for my own sake. Alright, so there are the whites of Tommy's eyes. Alright, and there are the whites of Finn's eyes. Alright, yeah, these are coming along nice. They look great. Okay. Rinse that off. And tell you what I'll do, actually, is it doesn't really matter what kind of black that I use for the pupils. So I'm going to use the black that I'm going to use on Tommy's boots here. I imagine that, you know, being a prim and proper rookie cop police officer, he's probably going to have some nice shiny boots. So I'm going to use a game color brand of paint here. This is Negro Black. The reason why I like this brand is because it's got just a little bit of a glossy kind of feel to it. It's not 100% gloss. It's more of like I said, a semi-gloss. And that just kind of looks nice for like shined leather or that kind of thing. Doesn't really matter what kind of brush that we use for this. You know, the base coat that I used for these miniatures has its own sort of gloss to it. So I don't think it's going to be a huge deal, whatever I do here. But yeah, you know, just if you've got more of a flat black for your base coat, then... you know, you might just want to go over it with a little bit of a gloss or semi-gloss black here. Okay, yeah, nice shiny boots there. Whoop, ah, almost dropped them. That's okay, we're good. All right, and I think what I'll go ahead and do is I'll just use the same thing for Finn's bottle here. I've never really messed with trying to make like glass colored. A glass coloration kind of thing for paint. There's probably some sort of way to do that, and I don't know, maybe I'll mess around with that or for a future video here, but I think for now I'll just use like it's an opaque glass. So we'll just go ahead and use this gloss black for the bottle here, and I think that will be fine. All right, I'm gonna let him dry. All right, so now using that same color, that same paint that we've got out on our little plastic surface there, I'm gonna go ahead and do the dots of their eyes just a little bit. Hopefully I can get Tommy to just kind of stare ahead here. It looks mostly all right. I think that one of his eyes here is a little crooked, a little janky, but that's okay. They'll be fine. All right. I think I did a better job with the whites of Finn's eyes here, so hopefully this will go a little bit better. And there we go. There are Finn's eyes there. That'll work out. They're a little bit prominent, a little bit thick, but that's okay. And I think that is actually it. Yeah, let me give these guys a little bit of a once over here just to kind of look them over, but yeah, I think that they look pretty nice actually. So, yeah, there you go, everybody. That's Finn Edwards and Tommy Muldoon from Mansions of Madness, specifically the expansion pack, Streets of Arkham. Thank you, everybody, for watching. If you want to see more miniatures being painted, if you want to see more nerdy hobby board game stuff, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. If you like the video, go and throw it a like. Yeah, I won't keep you guys any longer. Thank you again for watching. We'll see you next time on Let's Paint a Mini. Bye.